Matthew.
They just want to see me because it's a live.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. There we go. My name is Ian Liversidge. I'm very proud to be the principal at Garibaldi. If I'd have been able to go home today, I would have put some shorts on. It is so refreshing to get back to normal. Last week, we had our grad dinner dance, 160 kids celebrating their graduation, coming back to the school, staying till 5 a.m. at a dry grad event. Absolutely wonderful to be back to normal. On Monday this week, we had our grad ceremony, walking across the stage, the traditions that associate with that, and it's so nice to be back to normal. So thank you very much to Ms. Bell and team who put this together, and an outstanding evening in the sunshine for us, and whoever controls it, thank you very much. It is also an important part of our times where, in events like this, we take the time to recognize that we are hosting this event on the traditional and unceded territory of both the Catesy and Kwantlen First Nations. And as always, we recognize the ethnicity of others who are here. At our grad ceremony, it was the first time in many, many, many years where we actually had an opening welcome. Because the grad ceremony was held in Abbotsford, we had opening acknowledgements from three different communities. We had Catesy, we had Matsqui, and then we also had the opportunity to honor the Wanak First Nations, which is truly unique and truly truly special. And actually, the blessing came from a Garibaldi grad who is a member of Wanak First Nation. So that was pretty cool. So without further ado, is it you, Mr. Johnson, that is leading the first song?
It is.
I pass over to Mr. Bruce Johnson and the Elementary Band.
Hello. I apologize to the parents and the kids behind me. We saw each other yesterday for the first time. Mr. Kirkpatrick's sick, so I'm Mr. Kirkpatrick's fill-in. And hopefully they play as well as they did yesterday, and maybe even a little better with the sunshine and lots of warm claps. We're going to start with a warm-up, and then we're going to play Bringer of War and Squonk Blues.
Thank you. everybody. And while we're just changing groups, just a reminder that the concession is over. There's hot dogs, there's drinks, there's chips, there's cotton candy that's fresh out of the bowl. So help yourself while you're changing groups. And thanks for coming out and enjoying this wonderful night together.
Hello? Oh, hi.
Toby, can you play for a sec?
Hello.
Just anything?
How are y'all doing? Thank God it didn't rain. Because honestly, I feel like it's way better outside like this. Way better.
Can you hear the piano?
Sorry,
Like the forecast, although completely wrong, was saying it was gonna rain.
So, I think we're ready.
Oh boy.
We're gonna find out.
I was stressed.
All right, so we're just changing the order a tiny bit. We're gonna do Pennies from Heaven first. This song starts with a solo by that guy on the mic. This is Daniel, and he's gonna start us off, beginning of Pennies from Heaven. And then by the time we finish this song, my computer will be here and the file that I'm supposed to be using will work. So it'll work fine. Thanks for coming tonight, you guys. And Daniel's right. I'm so glad that it cleared up and we got such a nice evening. Because yesterday wasn't so great. All right.
Do your thing.
Should we just...
You
ready?
Yeah.
Daniel, come on. Daniel, you ready?
Okay. Yeah, I'm back. Okay.
Okay, are you all right?
So what I was saying about the rain, you know what they say? Every time it rains, it rains. And you know, the forecast said it was going to rain so hard it was almost raining pennies. So this song is perfect. Toby? A long time ago, a million
last things in life were absolutely free.
All right, we're just trying to adjust so you guys can hear us a bit better out there. No sound check. It's good times. The next song we're going to do for you is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. We have a few people in this group that joined us very recently in the last few weeks, maybe even 3 weeks, because we were doing a trip to Kelowna. I'm like, hey, we need more people in vocal jazz on the trip, so I stole band kids and said, here, learn this song. So this is one of the songs they learned. And the one they just sang, they learned Tuesday or something. I don't know. It was a little crazy. This is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Wasn't Daniel's solo great? Yes, there you go. I just didn't want to forget to do that. Ain't No Mountain, hope you enjoy this one. If you're in the next group, what's next? I don't know. Grade 8 band. Grade 8 band, you should get queued up and ready because you're next. Here is Ain't No Mountain.
Back there again. Thanks. Okay, ready, team? No idea how loud this can be, so we're going to find out in a sec. Stop, listen.
Thank you.
All right, so there's a few things you might need to know. I'm not sure if Mr. Liversidge said anything, so I'm just going to go through again. In case you came and you didn't have a chair and you don't want to sit on the wet grass, we do have extra chairs over there behind that awning tent thing. So feel free to grab one. We just need you to make sure you put it back on the chair cart afterwards. That would be grand. If you need to use the washroom, those doors right over there is where you go in, and then you turn right, and the washroom's closest to that spot is where you're going to use the washroom. Please, though, if you're inside the building, don't go wandering around. There's custodians working and cleaning and doing stuff, and we don't want to get in their way and make their jobs harder. So only in there if you need to use the washroom and then back out. That goes for students, too. I don't want students in the building. They had an interesting afternoon in the building. Right, Kaysen?
Yep.
It was quite amazing. I wish I had it on video. And it's a really good thing our custodians are nice. You have a video. Perfect. Something about a race car with a trombone up and down the hallways. Anyway, that being said, the other thing is hopefully you all received concert programs. We had some students wandering around handing them out to you, so hopefully they got to you. On that concert program, on the back side is the thank you list. So have a read through. We have so many people that help out during the year, even in a year that we didn't get to do as many things as we normally do. We still did a heck of a lot in the last 8 weeks. So have a look through the thank yous, and thank you to everybody that does help out. At the bottom of that thank you list is an admission by donation QR code link so that you can donate money digitally instead of in a basket somewhere. So we did say admission by donation for the concert. We'd love to get some donations from y'all for attending tonight. And if you don't want to do online or PayPal or whatever the heck it was set up with, I can't remember. I think they have some things over, look at them, they'll take your money anytime. So over there you could put some cash in the bin too. We weren't sure if it would be windy, so we didn't put just an empty instrument case out because we didn't know if it would blow away. So there you have it. We are about to start. Mr. Johnson earlier, did he get introduced? So Mr. Johnson that directed the elementary band, that was as of yesterday afternoon he was going to do that. We've had a variety of people covering for Mr. Kirkpatrick while he's been away sick. And he would love to be here, and I bet he's watching at home. And if you are watching at home, see what you're missing? Anyway, we had to replace him with like 10 people because apparently he does a lot of stuff. Mr. Johnson volunteered and covered elementary band yesterday afternoon, and then they said, we want you to conduct. So he's like, okay. So he did that. So thank you to Mr. Johnson for doing that last minute and stepping in. And then we also have other people helping out tonight, the first of which you're going to see directing the grade 8 band. So this is Ms. Gosling. She is one of our district's music TOCs. And when I say one of, I mean like one of three, but the other two are very unavailable usually. So Ms. Gosling is the person I go to and say, can you TOC? So she's been in with them 5 out of 10 days maybe at least. So she knew more. So we said, hey, can you come do the concert? So she's here tonight as well. So we're going to welcome Ms. Gosling conducting our grade 8 band on Vantage Point. That's what we said, right? Vantage Point is our first song. Enjoy.
Hello, Miss Bell.
the fan clubs back there. All right, so we're gonna do one more song for you. I'm gonna let Kaysen, I think, introduce it in a second, but I just thought of something while I was playing trumpet back there. We have a few people that are playing in this group tonight that are kind of filling in a little bit. We did a retreat. When was our retreat? Sometime in April-ish, to Loon Lake. And a few of our grade nines joined us because they got ripped off. What, you got robbed last year because they didn't get a retreat. So they came and joined us for the retreat and played some of the music with the grade eights. And then I was like, well, come play. So they're joining us tonight too. Any other people that I need to mention that were joining us? It is grade nines, right? They all want to be introduced individually, apparently. Anyway, I'm going to let Kaysen introduce this last tune that the Grade 8 Band is going to play for you tonight. Kaysen. Woo! Kaysen, thanks
for coming. Kaysen. Well, PG-13. Okay, fine. Hold on. Wait. Hello. Okay. So this song is called Funky Town. You probably have heard it before. It's by Steven Greenberg. I believe that's how you pronounce it. We don't like this song. It's one of our, like, least favorite songs because, I don't know, reasons. It's boring. And, yeah, I hope you enjoy.
Doesn't that make you excited to listen to it? This song is a song that, yeah, the bass instruments have kind of a boring part, so they get all like, eh, about it. But this is a song you guys are going to know and love. Feel free to dance along. Our chaperones at retreat did, and I was like, you guys, we have to play it for people because they're going to like it. So here's Funky Town.
Whether you like it or not.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
At this point, the grade 9 band is up. If you're in the audience, get over here quick. Hurry! And if you're in junior jazz band, grade 9s are only playing one tune, so get ready after that. All right, I think we're pretty much ready. Did y'all get your food over there? You got some hot dogs or cotton candy or chips or iced tea or I don't know, something good? I might have eaten a little bit of cotton candy before the concert started just to make sure I had enough energy. This group is our grade 9 band, most of it anyway. This group actually had class in the first semester. That was their class. And since the first semester, they've been meeting once a week at Flex because they want to. I think it's actually because we went to Victoria on a trip and they really wanted the trip. So they've been meeting to practice and rehearse. This is a song that a couple people kept hassling me about getting. In fact, I got a text of all the lyrics. It was a very long text from one of the students saying, actually, you didn't even say anything. You just texted me the lyrics. And I'm like, yeah. Are you trying to tell me something? What do you want? Anyway, so I bought the song so they could play it because apparently they wanted to. So this is Never Gonna Give You Up. Our grade 9 band, apparently they never give up either because they're still here. Ha! That was a good segue, hey? I'm going to play trumpet with them, so I'm not going to wave my arms around. Enjoy Never Gonna Give You Up. And in case you didn't hear me out there, if you're in junior jazz band, you are next up, so get ready. They're just doing one tune up here.
One, two, three, first.
All right, Junior Jazz is up. Come on over.
And while you're waiting for Junior Jazz to set up, there is no lineup at the concession, so if you want to go grab a hot dog or a drink, now's a great time.
Everybody, I've been alerted to the fact that I have to intro this group. What a concept. Like I was introduced earlier, my name is Miss Gosling. I've been teaching these guys the last couple weeks while Mr. Kirkpatrick has been away. However, I will not actually be up here waving my arms around, and I do not play a trumpet, so I will also not be in the group. So these guys are fully capable of counting themselves in and are gonna be doing that, snaps for them. They are going to be playing a little tune for you that you might recognize called Play That Funky, no, that was the other group. That is them, Play That Funky Music. And, sorry? Gotta play out a pull out a funk tune, no one says, agreed. Okay, what did you say? We have a lot of funk tunes this year, my bad. Okay. Please welcome the Junior Jazz Band.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so our grade 10 band is about to play for you. This is a song called A Klezmer Carnival. It has lots of moods in it, but it's really a big party. So we hope you enjoy this one, grade 10 band. And if you are in senior band, you guys are getting ready because we have both of you all on stage next. All right, this is Klezmer Carnival.
Good to go? his teachers over here to help. Just help him. Like, I'm doing everything.
Thank you.
right, so this group is made up of our grade 10, which have their own class, and 11, 12s, which have their own class. We put them together for our trip that we took to Kelowna a week and a half ago. And they played some songs together. So it challenged the grade 10s to play at a little bit higher level, and it also gave us one group to play with instead of two different groups. So this first song is called Ange in Blue-Eyed Samurai. Do I have to tell? Oh, there's also some people in here that are not in grade 10, 11, or 12, in case you can see them. They also came as chaperones on our trip, and they also play instruments. So I'm like, hey, you should play with us again. All right, so Tim over there on trumpet, cornet, whatever it is tonight, and Brian over there on trombone, they're joining us tonight as well. Is there anybody else that like is random adults? Yes, give them a clap. I mean, they haven't played yet, so you might want to wait. I don't know. All right, this is Anjin. Hope you enjoy this one. So here's the deal. This song starts with an ocean drum. You're gonna hear the ocean all the way out here in Maple Ridge, but you have to be very quiet. Here it is.
Thank you.
So as we were playing this song, I realized that I gave you a bit of wrong information. Brian and Tim were chaperones, but they weren't on the same trip. So Brian's sight reading, he was on the Victoria trip 2 weeks before the Kelowna trip. They're all together in my brain now. All right, we're going to play one more song together as a full group, and then the senior band are going to do a couple of tunes together. This song is a really cool piece of music with some really interesting sound effects. We spent like 20 minutes of a class looking up really weird machines. If you ever do this on YouTube, there's all kinds of very strange machines. Because this piece is called Extraordinary Machines of Clockwork and Steam. It's a Scott Watson piece. You'll hear all kinds of different noises meant to sound like a steam engine or a steam, some sort of machine with steam starting up. And Victor, did you play this song like, I don't know, 10 years ago? I think so too. Feels like 10 years ago. I think it was 3. But anyway, you'll know this tune. You could have played too. Huh. All right, Extraordinary Machines of Clockwork and Steam.
Chewed on some cotton during that last song.
Thank you.
All right, we're just doing another little switch. Our grade 10s are vacating for a second. Our senior bands are going to play a couple songs for you. And those of you out there that have instruments and play stuff, we're going to do Eagle Song after two more songs. So if you're grade 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, I don't know what other grades. Oh, we have senior jazz still. Senior jazz. I can't forget. Okay, there's like four more songs. You got a little time. Relax. Okay, I think we're ready to go. We just have some technical difficulties with page turns and plexiglass over our music so it doesn't blow away. Apparently, you can't flip the page when it's covered in plexiglass. But anyway, they'll figure it out. So this next tune is called Traffic Circle, and it introduces a new instrument of our band. So once upon a time, I did this tune with another group, and I was like, I need real car horns honking sounds. So one of my people that I know, Al Ketchison, in case you're watching, he went to a yard with cars and parts and stuff, and he found some horns, and he put them into this cool little tackle box thing and hooked it up to a, yeah. And it has buttons, and Ethan and Maya get a little carried away with it, but it's fun. So we get to make real, real car horn honking sounds in a piece called Traffic Circle. In case you've never been in a traffic circle, well, you know, imagine yourself. Here we go. Thank you. Have to sometimes, right? Okay, this next tune is called Erie Canal Jazz. I'm going to go back and join Arden because he doesn't have some of his section with him and he feels lonely. So, Erie Canal Jazz. If you're in senior jazz, just be waiting at the side so we can come right on after this tune. Thank you. Okay. Hello. Hey, Richard. Hi there. Hey, so we've got a couple guys that have been with us through thick and thin last year and this year, I think. Richard over there that's hugging the child, he's on our soundboard, but also live streaming and doing all that stuff and setting up sound. And because Mr. Kirkpatrick normally does that job, we did our best and then they filled in. So thank you for doing everything. And then we've got Tim over here on the camera doing the live stream camera work, but also helped with all the sound stuff and techie stuff and all that stuff that makes my brain explode. So thank you so much to the two of them, because really without them, you guys would not be able to watch at home. It would not happen. I'd be like, sorry, you missed it. So thank you to the two of them big time for all their help. Yes, give them the clap. All right, so our senior jazz is about to do a couple tunes. We're doing a piece called Cold Duck Time. Owen over there on Barry Sax likes to pick music for us to play. Some of it's way too hard. Most of it's super cool. This one is actually accessible. So Cold Duck Time, they all have weird names, but you know, it's not called Crunchy Frog like another one we have, so.
Thank you.
All right, grade 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You all should be, like, ready to roll. We have one more tune for senior jazz, and then we are doing a mass band piece of Eagle Song. If, you guys can hear me? If you are going to join that side of the band for Eagle Song, you will head that way and grab a stand and then just glom in. And if you're going to stand over here, you're going to grab a stand over here and glom in. You're not going to move yet, though, because we have one more tune. Is that cool? Thumbs up? Let's assume they know what I'm talking about. All right, the next tune. Yeah, right? You can be wherever you want to be, just be. I should have mentioned in that last song, we had a couple solos. We had Eric on tenor sax, we had Riley on alto sax, we had Nabby on many drum fills. So, yay them, woo! And now on this tune, I don't need the background, it's okay. On this tune, Sesame Street theme. Can you guess what we named this concert after? I'm giving you a big clue, you guys. What's this song? What are the first words of this song? Sesame Street. Sunny Days. Yeah? No? Yes? All right. So, Sunny Days concert. We are trying to figure out names, and you do not want to know what some of the names they suggested were. So, Sunny Days was a good, hopeful kind of name. And it was raining that day, and we were kind of like, come on now, let's have some summer. So, Sesame Street theme. It's like the title of the concert. We have some solos in this. We have Vibes. Oh my, Nabby, you're so famous. So Nabby's gonna play Vibes. I'm gonna try to mic her with this mic over here so you can hear it. And then we have another solo over here in the middle of the trombone section hiding. This is the bass clarinet. It's an unusual jazz instrument, but I've heard it in Ellington bands, so you know it exists. It was actually quite common in Duke Ellington stuff. So Logan's gonna do a very cool, awesome bass clarinet solo. No pressure, sorry. What was that? And we gotta hurry up. Yes, got it. Sesame Street, here we go.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. We're gonna have one last song for you, Eagle Song. Mass Band, come on. If there's a chair, grab it. If there's not, don't. If you need a chair, definitely grab it. All right, you guys get organized. I'm going to talk for a sec, okay? Get organized. We have one more song for you. Mr. Liversidge, did you have anything you wanted to say before our last song? And then I'll introduce it. So we had a team of people here tonight helping, because apparently, as I said, when Mr. Kirkpatrick's not here, we need 10 people to replace him. So in addition to the people I already introduced you to, we also had Miss Biscaya somewhere out there. Miss Miller was somewhere out there helping. We had, those were our two main like people to get people onto stage. That was great. So thank you to them big time. We also had all our music parent committee doing food for you over there and sending out donation tins. I saw Quinn going around asking for money. Did that work, Quinn? Where are you? Oh, it's okay. He left with the money. No, he did not. If you didn't have a chance to yet and you didn't have cash on you and you want to do a donation for our concert, that QR code on the back of your program will work. Mr. Liversidge.
Thank you. Round of applause for all the adults who gave time. Please, thank you. It is always a challenge at this time to make sure that everybody can fit in and collect and connect, and it's a blessing to have staff waiting in the wings that want to help and be connected with our community, and you are part of that community, so thank you, Natasha and Ms. Gosling. Additionally, I always try and support people for Good Husband Awards. Mr. Johnson, please give these to your beautiful wife. No, you have to give them to her. I didn't get anything for you. My gift to you, Mr. Johnson, was to get you in good standing. Now you're in good standing, so you've given the flowers. With sincerity, you can go now. With sincerity, there are people who connect with kids, and there are people who connect kids and build programs. And I was flipping through the phone, sitting over there looking at, in a COVID year, we've still had, you know, a half dozen concerts. We've still had two field trips. We've still had retreats. We've still had all of those events. In a year that's been truncated, cut in half, affected, etc. So that speaks well to the quality and characteristics of the people who want to build programs. And programs connect kids to school, and kids that are connected to school blossom. So thank you for your time and support of that. Thank you for the leadership that has given us the opportunity to do that. And I must say at this school, yes, with music, but also with fine arts and athletics and all kinds of other great stuff we've got going on here. So thank you very much. Enjoy the last song. I do know I'm going to give the mic back. There's cleanup responsibilities that need to not be missed.
It's going to be so fast.
It'll be fast, though. Ms. Bell, and thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Liversidge. All right, so just before our last song, as Mr. Liversidge said, the students will help. It will take like 5 minutes, right? They're going to help get all this stuff off the stage and down to the music room, and it'll look like a big tornado hit the place tomorrow, but that's fine. So we're going to get everything down, and parents, if you want to help them do that, then it speeds things along. But otherwise, make sure that any of the blue chairs that were borrowed from the racks over there get put back on the racks so we can take those in. And a final thank you. I think it's a final. No, two more. Oh, I'm so glad I just looked at you. I circled it on my thing. Photos. So Ms. Vandemont, and actually I talked to Victor, who manned the camera for a little bit, did some photos for us tonight, as well as covered for Tim when I made him go play trumpet. So thank you to both Marta and Victor for doing photos and manning the camera tonight. Thank you. I had another thought, but it's gone. And for you, it's a lovely evening. Isn't this a nice way to do a final concert of the year? Yeah. And was it nice to have food too? Hey, look at that. So thank you to all of you for being here as our audience, for supporting all these amazing students behind me throughout the year. And we had some students, as I said, that had a class first semester and then carried through. My grade 8 class was the same way. So that grade 8 band you saw near the beginning of this concert, half of them also didn't even have a class, and they just kept coming once a week to carry on playing. So it's been really fantastic for them. They reminded me that there's, on their marks that they get, there's this thing called exceeding, and they figure that because they carried through the year, they all should get 8s now. And I'm like, right? That kind of makes some sense. Exceeding, yes. So there you go. I'll try to figure that out. All right, this last song we're going to perform for you as this massive band. Oh, yeah, but we're going to do other. Kiara's just saying some of the grade 12s, this is their last song performance, but they don't know that I'm going to make them go play in Blue Mountains Field next week or something. Depends if it's raining. We're going to do some, like, I don't know. We're coming over to do a concert. Bring your people out. We'll see. So it's not quite their last, but last with everybody. I normally would recognize grade 12s at a concert, and we're going to recognize grade 12s, but we get to have a barbecue next Friday. So our music family's barbecue that has been put on hold for 3 years is back. I will send an email. I have it all queued up, ready to go, but I haven't pressed send yet. So I'll send an email with a link so you can sign up so we can make sure we have enough food for that. But it's out at Wanak Lake at the gazebo. It's not going to rain. It's going to be perfect, just like tonight was. And that is next Friday. Oh, I always believe. It just has to be done. Next Friday. So if you can make it, we're going to recognize our grads and our volunteers and our chaperones and all those people you see on the program next Friday. Okay, this song. is a super amazing song, and it's going to be really cool to do with a big group. This piece of music is called Eagle Song, and the person that, I'm not going to say composed it, because he didn't. He adapted it from a melody that was given to him, gifted to him, from Bob Baker, a Squamish First Nations elder, and he adapted it for concert band. It's a really, really, really unique piece of music, and we're really proud to be able to play it. 4 years ago, when we planned our district festival that we finally did this year, we decided that all the groups should play this song and experience what it was and then be able to hear each other play it. This way, we did that at festival this year, but now they're going to all play together. So they've never rehearsed this together. They were like, hey, we probably should have had a rehearsal. I'm like, hey, it's tomorrow and on time, so. It's been a little busy lately. All those things Mr. Liversidge said happened in the last month and a half. So it's been a little bit go, go, go. It has been hectic. We hope you enjoy this last song of the evening. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. And safe travels. Enjoy the rest of your week. Mr. Kirkpatrick, if you're at home watching us, which you should be, these guys want to dedicate this song to him. So hope you're feeling better soon, because I can't do this by myself anymore. Hope you're feeling better, and we hope you enjoy this last song. Thank you so much. Have a great rest of your evening. Students, carefully. There's cement here. Clean up. Everything goes back. Thank you so much. Good night.